We are all born in families.
Všetci sme sa narodili do rodiny.
And we found families.
A všetci si vytvárame rodinu.
And therefore, it is impossible to live outside family.
A preto je nemožné žiť mimo rodiny.
Now, therefore, we need to know, first of all, what is marriage in God's plan?
A preto v prvom rade musíme vedieť, čo to znamená manželstvo podľa Božieho plánu.
And also, what is family in God's plan?
A čo to znamená byť rodina podľa Božieho plánu?
And we must also examine our own life and see whether we lived it.
A musíme preskúmať svoj vlastný život, či sme to naozaj žili.
And also we must be willing to change in the areas where we need correction.
A musíme byť ochotní zmeniť sa v oblastiach, ktoré potrebujú nápravu.
Some things we may not be able to, something that has happened in the past, we may not be able to change.
Niektoré veci, ktoré sa stali v minulosti, možno nebudeme schopní napraviť.
We can ask pardon from the Lord and change our life now.
Ale môžeme prosiť Boha o odpustenie a zmeniť život teraz.
And therefore, it is a challenge to renew our lives.
A je to výzva obnoviť svoj život.
Now we hear, first of all, in Genesis chapter 1, verse 26.
V knihe Genesis, v prvej knihe, v šiestom verši.
God telling, let us make man in our own image and after our own likeness.
Boh hovorí, že chce stvoriť človeka podľa svojho obrazu.
So, it's a decision of the divine family.
Je to rozhodnutie svätej Božej rodiny.
Father, Son and the Holy Spirit decided to make human beings.
Otec, Syn a Duch Svätý sa rozhodli stvoriť človeka.
And we need to know what is the very nature of God.
A preto my musíme vedieť, čo to je, aká je vlastnosť Boha.
The Heavenly Father, the source of all life, empties himself and gives himself to Son.
Nebeský Otec, prameň života, sa úplne vyprázdňuje a celkom sa odovzdáva Synovi.
And the Son, in the same way, empties himself and gives himself back to the Father.
A Syn sa rovnakým spôsobom celý vyprázdni a odovzdáva sa Otcovi.
And the love of the Father for the Son and Son's love for the Father is the Holy Spirit.
A láska Otca voči Synovi a Synova láska voči Otcovi je Duch Svätý.
In all three of them, what you find is the selfless love.
Všetkých troch charakterizuje nezišná, nesebecká láska.
And this selfless love is the character of God.
A nesebecká láska je vlastnosťou Boha.
And in this image, God has created man and woman.
A Boh podľa tohto vzoru stvoril muža a ženu.
That's why we said we are created in God's image.
A preto hovoríme, že sme stvorení na Boží obraz.
And therefore, in order to show the unity of the family, the unity of the marriage.
A preto, aby sme ukázali jednotu manželstva.
God first created Adam.
Boh najprv stvoril Adama.
And then, out of him, he brought forth a woman.
A z neho vytvoril ženu.
And when he saw her, he was fully happy.
A keď ju uvidel, tak bol veľmi šťastný.
She is the flesh of my flesh and the bone of my bone.
Je to telo z mojho tela a kosť z mojich kostí.
And they loved one another.
A milovali jeden druhého.
And this is the beginning of the human family.
A toto je začiatok ľudskej rodiny.
And then also we hear in verse 24, chapter 2, verse 24.
A takisto aj v druhej knihe Genesis, verš 24.
The God puts a rule for the family.
Boh stanovuje pravidlá pre rodinu.
A man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife and two of them become one body.
Preto muž opustí svojho otca i svoju matku a prilipne k svojej manželke a budú jedným telom.
So, since man and woman are created in God's image,
Keďže muž a žena sú stvorení na Boží obraz,
the husband is like God, Father, selflessly love his wife.
Manžel, takisto ako Boh otec, musí nesebecky milovať svoju manželku.
And like the son, the wife has to selflessly love her husband.
A takisto aj manželka, a on podobne ako syn Boží, musí nesebecky milovať svojho manžela.
Out of the selfless love of the husband and wife, a child is born who also will remain holy or selfless.
Z tejto nesebeckej lásky manželov sa narodí dieťa, ktoré bude sveté a nesebecké.
And therefore, the pattern of God's family must be brought into the human family.
A preto musíme tento vzor Božej rodiny preniesť do ľudskej rodiny.
And that is God's plan.
A toto je Boží plán.
And therefore, God was with them after their creation.
A Boh bol s nimi už od počiatku sveta.
And they enjoyed the presence of God.
A užívali si Božiu prítomnosť.
And in order to enjoy the family life, Archbishop Fulton Sheen says,
Arcibiskup Fulton Sheen hovorí,
that there are three to get married.
Že sú to traja ľudia, ktorí sú potrební k manželstvu.
Man and the woman.
Muž, žena.
And Christ at the center.
A Kristus, ktorý je uprostred.
And only then the family becomes a holy family.
Jedine vtedy sa rodina stáva svetou rodinou.
And therefore, if Christ is not there, the family may not be holy.
Ak tam nie je Kristus, rodina nemôže byť svätá.
Because each one will pull to his or her own side for living in a selfish way.
Pretože jeden alebo druhý budú ťahať tú rodinu svojou stranou podľa svojej sebeckosti.
And therefore it's important that Christ is at the center.
A preto je dôležité, aby bol Kristus centrom.
And therefore we hear that when a person marries, he must marry a person, a Catholic should marry a believing partner.
A preto je dôležité, aby si katolík zobral veriaceho partnera.
Because both have got same scriptural understanding of marriage.
Pretože obidvaja majú rovnaké chápanie písma, pokiaľ ide o manželstvo.
Both have got God's understanding of their own personality.
Obidvaja majú rovnaké Božie zmýšľanie svojej osobnosti.
And they can accept themselves.
On prijímajú samých seba.
They accept the other.
Prijímajú druhých.
And if there is a problem in the family, they can always look into the scripture how to settle our problem.
A ak v rodine nastane problém, môžu sa spoločne pozrieť do Božieho slova a vyriešiť ho.
And the community of the church can also help them to solve the problems.
A takisto aj cirkevné spoločenstvo môže pomôcť vyriešiť problém.
Therefore God says, when you marry, you must marry a person who has faith.
A preto Boh hovorí, ak sa vydávaš, ženíš, vezmi si partnera, ktorý má vieru.
In Deuteronomy chapter 7,
knihe Deuteronomiu o 7. kapitole,
verse 3 and 4.
Verše 3 a 4. Ani manželstvo s nimi neuzavrieš. Svoju dcéru nedáš za jeho syna a jeho dcéru nevezmeš svojmu synovi. Lebo ona by mohla tvojho syna odviesť odo mňa, takže by uctievali iných bohov a vzblúkol by pánov hnev a rýchlo by ťa vyhubil.
So, marriage is for happiness in life.
Manželstvo je pre šťastie a život.
And God gives certain rules for that.
A preto nám Boh pre manželstvo dáva určité pravidlá.
If you practice those rules, we obey those rules, there'll be joy and happiness in life.
Pokiaľ poslucháme tieto pravidlá, tak v našom živote bude radosť.
Therefore, marriage must be with a person who has got the same faith.
A preto manželstvo musí byť s osobou rovnakého vierovyznania.
And today what is happening is that we find somebody in the office or on the street or somewhere and we fall in love.
Mne sa mnohokrát stáva, že stretneme človeka niekde na ulici alebo v kancelárii a zamilujeme sa.
And we are not looking whether the other person has got faith or not.
Nehľadíme na to, či tá osoba je veriaca alebo nie.
I like that person.
Mám rád túto osobu.
I want to sleep with that person.
Chcem s ňou spať.
Even before the marriage, people get into the bed.
A ešte aj pred manželstvom sa takto ľudia dostávajú spolu do postele.
In other words, they are living without God's presence in their life.
A žijú bez Božej prítomnosti vo svojom živote.
God very clearly said, the most intimate relationship is between husband and wife.
A preto musíme jasne povedať, usmerniť tento vzťah medzi mužom a ženou.
And for that we must have first the relationship with God.
A preto musíme mať najprv vzťah s Bohom.
If you do not have the relationship with God, you are going to make many mistakes in your future.
Ak nebudeme mať vzťah s Bohom, v budúcnosti urobíme veľa chýb.
We also find in 2 Corinthians,
takisto aj v druhom liste Korinťanom,
chapter 6,
6. kapitole,
verse 14,
verš 14. Neťahajte jarmo s neveriacimi. Veď akú účasť má spravodlivosť na neprávosti? Alebo čo má spoločné svetlo s tmou?
So, like two animals are yoked together, the man and woman are yoked together for life. Yoked means animals are.
Takisto ako dve zvieratá majú spoločné jarmo, tak aj ľudské bytosti sú takto prepojené.
So in the olden times, you know, the tractor, at that time they used horses or bulls for plowing the field.
A v minulosti neexistovali traktory a ľudia používali zvieratá, či už konia alebo voli, na to, aby orali polia.
And therefore they employed two animals together.
A vtedy zapojili dve zvieratá spoločne.
And put a yoke around the neck.
Okolo krku im dali jarmo.
And therefore they could plow the field together.
Aby spoločne mohli orať pole.
So also God wants that a believing man and believing wife would they come together and enter into marriage.
A takisto aj Boh chce, aby veriaci muž a veriaca žena sa takto zjednotili a aby mali veriace manželstvo.
And therefore we should not marry somebody who has no faith.
Preto je dôležité, aby sme sa nevstúpili do manželstva s neveriacou osobou.
Faith does not mean whether that person was does not only mean that person was baptized sometime.
Neznamená to mnohokrát, či tá osoba iba mala krst alebo nie.
But most important is he is baptized and living the word of God.
Najdôležitejšie je, aby tá osoba bola pokrstená a aby žila Božie slovo.
There are many people who are baptized but they are not living the Christian faith or God's word.
Mnoho ľudí je pokrstených, avšak nežijú kresťanskú vieru ani Božie slovo.
And they are living like the pagans.
A žijú ako pohania.
And therefore, when I want to marry, I must see a person who has got faith and I can live with that person till the end of my life.
A keď sa chcem vstúpiť do manželstva, musím pozerať na to, či tá osoba má vieru, aby som s ňou mohol byť až do konca svojho života.
And also God says in the same verse, how can there be a partnership between a person who keeps God's law and who does not keep God's law?
Takisto sa tam hovorí, ako je možné mať vzťah medzi ľuďmi, ktorí dodržiavajú Božie slovo a nedodržiavajú ho.
One who keeps God's law is in the light.
A ten, ktorý dodržiava Boží zákon, je v práve.
One who does not live God's word is in darkness.
Ten, ktorý nedodržiava Boží zákon, je v temnote.
So can light and darkness stay together?
Môže svetlo a tma zostávať spolu?
And therefore, it says, it also finally says, what is common between Christ and Belial or devil?
A v tom verši sa píše, čo je spoločné medzi Kristom a diablom.
One who wants to follow Christ and the other one who wants to follow the devil, they cannot stay together.
Jeden chce nasledovať Krista, jeden diabla a preto nemôžu zostať spolu.
And therefore we need to choose a partner who has faith.
Preto si musíme vybrať partnera, ktorý má vieru.
That lives the faith.
Ktorý žije vieru.
And then yesterday as we saw, God is dwelling in the heart of that person.
God is
dwelling.
A vtedy Boh prebýva v srdci toho človeka.
And therefore their behavior will be like that God would like them to do.
A potom aj ich správanie bude také, aké chce mať Boh.
And remember, this is the first condition.
Toto je prvá podmienka.
If we do not do that, the consequence will come into our life.
Pokiaľ to tak neurobíme, následok príde do nášho života.
We find in Numbers
v knihe Numeri
32:23
32. kapitola
32:23
a 23. verš.
Then where we read, you will have sinned against the Lord, and you can be sure that the consequences of your sin will overtake you.
Sa píše, ak sa však nezachováte tak, previnite sa proti Pánovi a vedzte, že váš hriech vás dochytí.
And therefore, if you do sin,
ak hrešíte,
and then that sin will follow you wherever you go throughout your life.
Hriech vás bude nasledovať kamkoľvek pôjdete počas celého života.
That is what we find with the people who had sex before the marriage, and then they are forced to marry that person, and then whole life becomes miserable for them.
Toto sa deje aj ľuďom, ktorí majú sex ešte pred manželstvom, sú nútení zobrať si tú osobu a vynie sa to s nimi celým životom.
There will be problem with themselves, with the partner and with the children.
Majú problémy sami so sebou, so svojím partnerom aj so svojimi deťmi.
And also it goes to the next generations.
A prechádza to na ďalšie generácie.
So the wise God said, you follow my, have faith and follow my way.
Boh, ktorý je múdrosť, nám hovorí, počúvajte moje slovo a nasledujte vieru vo mňa.
And then we know that we are created spirit, mind and body.
Vieme, že sme stvorení duch, duša a telo.
So in the level of the spirit we must have the same faith.
A v úrovni ducha musíme mať rovnakú vieru.
In the level of the mind we must be able to share the heart together.
V úrovni mysle musíme byť schopní zdieľať sa navzájom.
You must be able to understand one another.
Musíme byť schopní chápať jeden druhého.
You must be able to love one another.
Milovať jeden druhého.
And now these things are not possible. After the marriage you will find it's a miserable place.
A tieto veci nie sú možné, pokiaľ je manželstvo nie je, je ubohé.
And therefore, before the marriage is the time for them to study the person and then love the partner and get married.
Preto je dôležité, aby ľudia študovali jeden druhého ešte pred manželstvom a až potom vstupovali do manželstva.
A former British Prime Minister Disraeli
bývalý izraelský premiér.
He married at the age of 35.
Sa oženil, keď mal 35 rokov.
And he proposed his desire to get married to another lady.
He got married.
No, he not to get married. He proposed his desire to get married to another lady. He shared.
A povedal o tom inej žene, že sa chce oženiť.
She also waited almost 1 year to study this man.
A ona čakala, táto žena, a snažila sa študovať ho.
And
takmer jeden rok.
Afterwards she agreed to get married to him.
A po tomto čase sa rozhodla, že s ním vstúpi do manželstva.
And they lived together 30 years.
A žili spolu
30
rokov.
And then they were very happy.
A boli veľmi šťastní.
Because they both want to adjust themselves to the other and love the other.
Pretože rešpektovali jeden druhého a milovali jeden druhého.
And therefore it is important that we study the other person, whether I can stay with that person or not.
A preto je dôležité, aby sme skúmali túto druhú osobu, či s ňou dokážem zotrvať alebo nie.
When we are growing up from puberty,
keď vyrastáme z puberty,
and then we will have sexual desires for different people or like different people,
a budeme mať sexuálne vzťahy alebo budeme mať radi iných ľudí rôznych,
it is the time to check who will be fitting for me.
Je dôležité v tomto čase skúmať, kto je vhodný partner pre mňa.
And therefore my body is holy and the other person's body also is holy.
Moje telo je sväté a telo môjho partnera je sväté.
That I want to give my body to somebody else whom I can really love for life.
A moje telo musím dať jedine tomu človeku, s ktorým chcem zostať na celý život.
Therefore, the marriage is the most important decision in one's life.
A preto rozhodnutie vstúpiť do manželstva je najdôležitejším rozhodnutím v živote človeka.
And therefore, it's important that they prepare for that and know what is going to happen.
Je dôležité pripraviť sa na to a potom už budeme vedieť zvládnuť to, čo príde.
Today, what is happening?
Čo sa deje dnes?
Come out of puberty.
Keď ľudia dospievajú.
They happen to see somebody or like somebody.
Náhodne sa buď zalúbia do niekoho, stretnú niekoho.
Often because of the external qualities.
Súdia na základe zovňajšku.
And then they get into the bed and finally they get married.
Idú spolu do postele a nakoniec sa zosobášia.
And after the marriage, problems begin.
A po manželstve sa začína problém.
Because we did not do the preparation that God wanted.
Pretože sme neuskutočnili prípravu, ktorú od nás chcel Boh.
In the book of Tobit we find.
V knihe Tobiáš nájdeme.
Sarah and Tobit were praying to God to give a right partner.
Že Sara a Tobiáš sa modlili za vhodného partnera, a ktorého im Boh má dať.
And therefore we find finally the archangel Raphael took Tobias from his place to the place where the girl was.
A potom vidíme, že archangel Rafael zobral Tobiaša z miesta, kde bol, a zobral ho k Sáre.
And when he looked at her, he liked her.
Keď sa na ňu pozrel, páčila sa mu.
But he said, I accept her as my sister.
Ale povedal, prijímam ju ako moju sestru.
Tobit chapter 8 verse 7 says.
Tobiáš 8. kapitola
7.
A verš 7 hovorí: Teraz si neberiem túto moju sestru z chlípnosti, ale s čistým úmyslom.
I accept her as my sister.
Prijímam ju ako moju sestru.
I respect her.
Rešpektujem ju.
I love her.
Milujem ju.
And then I accept her as my wife.
A neskôr ju budem prijímať ako moju manželku.
Today, what is happening?
Čo sa deje dnes?
Through the media, through our wrong experience in the past, we are filled with lust.
Cez médiá, cez naše zlé minulé skúsenosti, je naša myseľ naplnená žiadostivosťou.
And therefore we are not able to respect the other person.
Ani sme schopní rešpektovať druhých ľudí.
And therefore the behavior with the other person, even before the marriage, is lustful attitude and not a loving attitude.
A už vzťah ešte pred manželstvom s tou druhou osobou je naplnený žiadostivosťou.
One lady told me,
jedna pani mi raz povedala,
before the marriage I told my husband,
pred manželstvom som povedala môjmu manželovi,
please do not bring all the wrong attitudes that you had in your previous life to your marriage bed.
Prosím ťa, neber svoje zlé minulé skúsenosti do nášho manželstva.
I want you to respect me, I also want to respect you.
Chcem rešpektovať teba a ty rešpektuj mňa.
And therefore the women would like that a man who is respecting her and loving her.
Žena chcela muža, ktorý ju rešpektuje a miluje.
But there are people, because of their wrong behavior patterns with pornography or sex with another people, they have a wrong attitude and they will transfer that attitude into their marriage bed.
Avšak ľudia, ktorí majú zlé vzory správania, či už je to pornografia, tak to neskôr prenášajú aj do svojho manželského lôžka.
And often the woman dislikes it.
A väčšinou sa to žene nepáči.
And therefore she will lose her interest in the partner very much.
A potom veľmi ľahko strácame záujem o partnera.
Because she is being used rather than loved.
Pretože žena bola používaná, nie milovaná.
And therefore it's important that man sees the other one as a person to be respected.
A preto je dôležité, aby sa muž pozeral na ženu s úctou, s rešpektom.
And we also find in the same place that when the bed came to the bed, first they prayed to the Lord.
A na rovnakom mieste takisto čítame, že keď sa Tobiáš so Sarou dostali k posteli, tak sa spolu modlili.
That God has to bless their marriage, which is for life.
Aby Boh požehnal ich manželstvo, ktoré je na celý život.
And they want to live that life according to the way God patterned it.
A chceli žiť svoj život podľa Božieho vzoru.
Please read the same chapter, chapter 8, verse 5 to 9.
Kapitola 8, verše 5 to 9.
5 to 9. Chapter 8, verse 5 to 9.
Verše 5 až... Verše 5 až 9. Ona vstala a začali sa modliť a prosiť Pána, aby im daroval spásu. Začali slovami: Zvelebený buď, Bože, našich otcov. Nech je zvelebené Tvoje meno po všetky veky vekov. Nech Ti dobrorečia nebesia i všetko Tvoje stvorenie po všetky veky. Ty si stvoril Adama a utvoril si Evu, jeho ženu, aby mu pomáhala a podporovala ho. Z oboch vzišlo celé ľudské pokolenie. Ty si povedal, nie je dobre človeku samému. Urobme mu pomoc, ktorá mu bude podobná. Teraz si neberiem túto moju sestru z chlípnosti, ale s čistým úmyslom. Zmiluj sa dobrotivo nado mnou i nad ňou, aby sme sa spoločne dožili staroby.
Now, what is the consequence of this prayer?
Aký je dôsledok tejto modlitby?
There were seven other people who wanted to marry this girl, but before their joining with her in the bed, they all died.
Sedem ďalších mužov chcelo vstúpiť do manželstva s touto dievčinou, avšak predtým, ako spoločne zdieľali lôžko, zomreli.
Because they approached her without God, with lust.
Pretože k nej pristupovali bez Boha, so žiadostivosťou.
She was praying to God and therefore she was protected.
Modlila sa k Bohu a preto bola ochránená.
And then Tobias came.
Potom prišiel Tobiáš.
And there was a demon in Sarah.
A v Sáre bol démon.
His name was Aspendeus.
A jeho meno bolo Aspendeus.
And he went away from her because they prayed together.
A on z nej vyšiel, pretože sa oni dvaja spoločne modlili.
And therefore, dear friends, it's important that you pray in the family together.
A preto je, drahí priatelia, dôležité, aby ste sa spoločne modlili v rodine.
There is a saying in English that the family that prays together stays together.
A v angličtine je také príslovie: rodina, ktorá sa spolu modlí, zostane so sebou. Len sa to rímuje.
I had gone to a family in Kerala and there the parish had no place for our stay, so we stayed in a family. The family, we had to stay in a family because in the parish there was no place for us to stay.
Museli sme raz zostať v rodinách, pretože vo farnosti pre nás nebolo miesto.
And what I noticed was every day at 7 o'clock everyone would come home back from all the business and would pray together.
A čo som spozoroval bolo, že rodina sa okolo 7 po práci zišla a spoločne sa modlili.
And there was a lot of blessing in that family.
A v tej rodine bolo cítiť veľké Božie požehnanie.
And if you do not give first place to God and really relate ourselves to God, then we are going to destroy our own family.
Ak nebudeme Bohu dávať prvé miesto vo svojom živote, tak svoju rodinu zničíme.
And the most important thing in our life, in the marriage, is the will to get married.
V manželstve je veľmi dôležité rozhodnúť sa vstúpiť do manželstva, byť ochotný.
The man and the woman must be willing to get married the other person out of love.
Muž a žena musia byť ochotní vstúpiť do manželstva s touto osobou z lásky.
So there are some marriages where the force is coming in. Somebody else forces them to get married to somebody.
V niektorých manželstvách sa stáva, že ľudia sú nútení vstúpiť do manželstva.
It could be the parents.
Sú to buď rodičia.
Maybe the boy.
Alebo chlapec.
Or the girl.
Alebo dievča.
And if there's force, the marriage will not last.
A pokiaľ tu je nejaké násilie, tak to manželstvo nepretrvá.
And therefore, we must see whether there is full will to get married and there is no force.
A preto je dôležité zistiť, či tam je úplná ochota alebo či tam je nejaké zasahovanie do toho.
Also, similarly, there should not be any fear.
Nemal by tam byť žiadny strach.
If somebody is entering into marriage out of fear, then there is no real love for the other.
Pokiaľ niekto vstupuje do manželstva zo strachu, tak nemá v sebe skutočnú lásku voči tomu druhému.
We already heard yesterday, where there is love, there is no fear.
Včera sme počuli, kde je láska, tam nie je strach.
Where there is fear, there is no love.
Kde je strach, tam nie je láska.
And when you enter into the marriage, enter the marriage with the perfect love for the partner.
Do manželstva musíme vstupovať s dokonalou láskou voči partnerovi.
And only then the marriage will last.
Jedine vtedy manželstvo vydrží.
And there I have seen also cases where especially women somehow run away with somebody because they were not loved at home.
Videl som prípady, kedy zväčša ženy utiekli s nejakým mužom, pretože sa necítili milované.
Once in Germany, after preaching a retreat in a retreat center, the director took me to a sick lady.
Raz počas duchovných cvičení v Nemecku ma jeden riaditeľ zobral k jednej chorej pani.
And the father said, that lady is sick for a long time, she's better than, would you go and pray with her?
Povedal mi, tá pani je už dlhodobo chorá, mohli by ste sa prosím prísť za ňu pomodliť?
So when I went there, I saw the husband was serving her like a slave.
A keď som tam vošiel, všimol som si, že jej manžel sa k nej správal ako gotrokovi.
He really loved her. He really loved her.
So he was not treating her like a slave.
He was legally serving. She was sick, therefore he was serving her, and he really loved her.
Takže nesprával sa k nej ako gotrokovi, ale ako otrok jej slúžil. Naozaj ju zo srdca miloval.
Stand. Please don't stand up and down. You will sit somewhere, otherwise we are disturbed. The lady is standing there.
Ale poďte si kľudne sadnúť sem niekde. Nestojte tam vo dverách. Poďte kľudne tu do miesta.
She doesn't understand.
No, she doesn't want to.
So, I stood there for half an hour.
Stal som tam pri tej bani aj manželovi asi 30 minút.
She was only complaining about her husband.
A iba sa sťažovala, neustále sa sťažovala na svojho manžela.
And then I said stop.
A potom som povedal stop, zastavte sa.
I said, I am not come to hear about the complaints about your husband.
A neprišiel som sem počúvať sťažnosti na vášho manžela.
What is your problem?
A ja som prišiel kvôli vašim problémom.
And then she began to say her problem.
A vtedy začala rozprávať svoje problémy.
She was conceived before the marriage.
Bola počatá ešte pred manželstvom.
And then because she was conceived before the marriage, both the partners were forced to marry one another.
She was pregnant. Yeah. Ona bola tehotná, otehotnila ešte pred manželstvom a neskôr bola donútená vstúpiť do manželstva s týmto mužom.
But they had no intention to get married.
Avšak oni dvaja nemali úmysel vziať sa.
Now they began to blame this child. It's because of you that we got married.
A začali obviňovať toto dieťa. Je to iba kvôli tebe, že sme sa museli zobrať.
And then child was rejected.
Dieťa bolo odmietnuté.
Child was made to work hard at home.
Dieťa muselo doma tvrdo pracovať.
She was punished.
Bola trestaná.
Because the husband and wife did not want to get married to one another.
Pretože muž a žena sa nechceli vziať.
When she was around 16 or so, a young man showed a little affection for her.
Keď mala asi 16, tak jeden mladý muž preukázal city voči nej.
And then she ran away with him.
A ona s ním utiekla.
Not to get married, but to get away from the persecution of the family.
Nie, aby sa vydala za neho, ale aby utiekla od prenasledovania zo strany svojej rodiny.
And they got married.
Zobrali sa.
But she did not like many things about his life.
Ale veľa vecí sa jej nepáčilo na tomto živote.
The basic reason was she did not want to get married to him.
A základným dôvodom bolo, že ona sa za ňo nechcela vydať.
She only wanted to get away from the family.
Chcela sa iba dostať preč zo svojej rodiny.
And therefore she had only complaints about it.
A preto sa iba na neho neustále sťažovala.
And I said, your problem is here.
A som jej povedal, váš problém je práve tu.
You did not accept yourself.
Neprijali ste sama seba.
And you are not able to accept this person.
Neprijali ste ani tú druhú osobu.
You do not want to love this person.
Nechcete milovať túto osobu.
He was only a means to get out of your family.
On bol iba prostriedok, ako sa dostať z vašej rodiny.
And since you don't have love for him, you are criticizing him for every little thing about him.
A keďže ho nemilujete, tak sa sťažujete na každú jeho chybičku.
Then I helped her from the time she was conceived in the mother's womb before the marriage till that time.
Modlil som sa s ňou za obdobie, keď bola počatá ešte pred manželstvom až celý život.
And then she felt relieved for the problems that she had.
A cítila úľavu z problémov, ktoré mala.
And she said, Father, you are the first one to tell about this, my real problem.
A povedala mi, Pater, ste prvý človek, ktorý mi povedal o mojich skutočných problémoch.
When we don't accept ourselves, we find difficult to accept others.
Keď máme problém prijať samých seba, máme problém prijať aj druhých ľudí.
And many people after marriage find problem with others because they are not able to accept themselves.
A práve mnoho ľudí má aj v manželstve problém spôsobený tým, že nie sú schopní prijať samých seba.
And therefore we need to have certain maturity as we enter into marriage.
A preto pred vstupom do manželstva musíme dosiahnuť istú zrelosť.
I must be a person who accept myself and love myself.
A musím byť osoba, ktorá miluje sama seba a ktorá prijíma sama seba.
And therefore I'm able to love the other.
A vtedy budem pripravený milovať druhého.
And only then the marriage of both will be happy one.
Jedine vtedy to manželstvo obidvoch bude šťastné.
If they are psychologically and emotionally sick, that problem will be coming through them to the relationship between the partners.
Pokiaľ jeden z nich je psychologicky alebo emočne nestabilný, tak to bude prechádzať do ich života aj na druhého partnera.
And it will come to the children.
Aj na deti.
And then you are destroying the next generation.
A potom budeme ničiť ďalšie generácie.
So therefore it's important that you have got you accept yourself and you really will to marry the other person.
Preto je dôležité prijať sám seba a mať ochotu vstúpiť a vôľu vstúpiť do manželstva.
In the Christian marriage, what we understand is that the marriage is for life.
Vieme, že v kresťanskom živote je manželstvo na celý život.
Because it's a covenant made between God and the two people.
Je to zmluva uzatvorená medzi Bohom a dvoma ľuďmi.
In the secular society, what they have got is only a contract.
To, čo je v sekulárnej spoločnosti, je to iba akási písomná zmluva.
Because they do not believe in a God.
Pretože neveria v Boha.
And therefore, two people give right to the other to enjoy one another's body.
A títo dvaja ľudia dávajú tomu druhému právo užívať si ich telo.
And therefore when they dislike the other, they can divorce it.
Keď sa im ten druhý človek znepáči, tak ho môžu sa dať rozviesť.
Christian marriage is not that.
Kresťanské manželstvo to tak nie je.
It is a lifelong giving of oneself to the other in the presence of God.
Je to dávanie jeden druhého na celý život v Božej prítomnosti.
So therefore since it is for life, that promise made between God before God, therefore it is, marriage cannot be broken.
Je to sľub, ktorý dávame Bohu a je to sľub na celý život a preto nemôže byť zrušený.
Therefore it is equality, indissoluble, it cannot be broken.
Manželstvo je nerozlučiteľné.
And also they must be willing to have children.
Takisto títo ľudia musia byť ochotní prijímať deti.
So they may have children or they may not have children.
Buď môžu mať deti alebo nemôžu mať deti.
But they must be open to have children.
Ale musia byť otvorení prijať deti.
Because we find in Genesis chapter 1 verse 28.
V prvej knihe Genesis verš 28.
God said, increase and multiply.
A Boh povedal,
then fill the earth.
Množte sa a naplňte zem.
And therefore, it is the duty of the parents to bring more people to heaven that they bring forth the new children.
A preto je dôležité, aby rodičia prinášali nových ľudí do neba a aby mali deti.
If there is no desire to bring forth children, then there is no proper marriage. Not a Catholic marriage.
Pokiaľ to nie je túžba privádzať deti na svet, tak to nie je skutočné kresťanské manželstvo.
And there must be love between the partner, there must be unity.
Medzi manželstvom, manželmi musí byť láska, jednota.
And that they realize that marriage is for life.
Musia si byť vedomí toho, že manželstvo je na celý život.
And they must be open for children.
A musia byť otvorení prijať deti.
If any of this is not there, then there is no marriage.
Pokiaľ jedno z týchto troch chýba, tak to nie je manželstvo.
And therefore, if these the elements are not there, they can have a divorce. Or not divorce, an element of the marriage.
Pokiaľ tam nie sú tieto tri veci prítomné, môže prísť k anulácii manželstva.
And therefore, the church gives some 3 weeks before the marriage to know more about these things.
A preto cirkev dáva približne dáva čas pred manželstvom, aby sme sa dozvedeli o týchto veciach.
And there the bands are, you know what's band? No. That is 3 times in the church they proclaim that they are going to be married.
A takisto sú bývajú v niektorých farnostiach ohlášky, že trikrát sa ohlasuje o týchto ľuďoch, že ktorí sa idú vziať.
It is to know that they are really prepared for the marriage.
A je to robené z dôvodu, aby boli naozaj pripravení na manželstvo.
Therefore, if there is no, if these three elements are not there, then there is no marriage.
Pokiaľ tieto tri veci nie sú prítomné, nedochádza k manželstvu.
So, it was a time before the marriage, you must examine it.
Preto čas pred manželstvom je dôležitý a musíme ho skúmať.
And even after the marriage, if they come to know that they cannot live with one another because of these reasons, the marriage can be annulled.
Pokiaľ aj po uzavretí manželstva zistíme neprítomnosť jedného z týchto faktorov, môže prísť k anulácii manželstva.
The marriage becomes married first when they make the promise before the altar, before the priest in the church.
Manželstvo sa uzatvára tým, že sa dáva sľub kňazovi pred Božím oltárom.
And the priest is the sign of Christ.
Kňaz je symbolom Krista.
And therefore they are making this promise before God.
To znamená, že títo dvaja robia sľub pred Bohom.
And therefore they also should mean that they will these things for their marriage.
A musia preukázať aj vôľu robiť tieto veci neskôr v manželstve.
Now, though the marriage is celebrated in the church, the marriage is complete when husband and wife become physically one.
Manželstvo sa uzatvára v kostole, avšak je naplnené až prvým manželským spolužitím.
And suppose there was no union between husband and wife after the celebration in the church.
Predpokladajme, že po slavnosti v kostole nedošlo ešte k naplneniu manželstva.
And that marriage can be annulled.
Tak toto manželstvo môže byť anulované.
Because the marriage becomes complete when husband and wife join together and become one body.
Pretože manželstvo je naplnené až v čase, kedy sa muž a žena stanú jedným telom.
And after that, nobody on earth can separate them.
A potom ju už nikto na zemi nemôže odlúčiť.
Therefore we find in Mark chapter 10
v Marekovom evanjeliu v 10. kapitole
verse 7 to 9
verse 7 až 10 čítame. Preto muž opustí svojho otca i matku a pripúta sa k svojej manželke a budú dvaja v jednom tele. A tak už nie sú dvaja, ale jedno telo. Čo teda Boh spojil, nech človek nerozlučuje.
So here we find when we marry that the partners leave the parents and become one with the partner.
Tu čítame, že keď človek vstupuje do manželstva, opustí svojich rodičov a stáva sa jedno so svojim partnerom.
See, we have got different stages in our growth.
Máme rôzne stupne nášho rastu.
The first stage is from the moment of conception till child is born in the mother's womb.
A prvé štádium je od momentu počatia až do pôrodu.
And secondly, from the moment of birth till they're getting married, who are about 18-20 years old.
A druhé obdobie je od obdobia pôrodu až do veku približne 18 až 20 rokov, alebo teda do obdobia, kedy vstupujú do manželstva.
And till in this period they give, in all this period they give first place to God in their life.
V tomto období dávajú prvé miesto Bohu.
And the second place they give to the parents.
A druhé miesto dávajú svojim rodičom.
And then the third place to our brothers and sisters and so on.
Tretie miesto svojim súrodencom.
But once the marriage takes place, this changes.
Avšak, keď vstúpime do manželstva, tieto veci sa zmenia.
Because relationship husband and wife is more intimate than the parents and children.
Pretože vzťah medzi mužom a ženou je intimnejší ako vzťah medzi tým človekom a jeho rodičmi.
And even after marriage, God has got the first place in the marriage, in the life of married couples.
A v manželských pároch má Boh stále prvé miesto.
Then second place goes to the partner.
A druhé miesto patrí manželskému partnerovi.
And third place, if there are children, then children get the third place.
Tretie miesto dostávajú deti.
And then fourth the parents.
A až štvrté miesto dostávajú rodičia.
But sometimes what happens is this, that they give first place to their parents.
Avšak mnohokrát sa stáva, že ľudia dávajú prvé miesto svojim rodičom.
And when they give first place to the parents, they are not able to give that place, the proper place to their partner.
A keď rodičia dostanú prvé miesto, tak nie sú schopní dávať správne miesto svojmu partnerovi.
Often the mother of the boy and the girl tries to control their life.
Mnohokrát sa matky, či už dievčatia alebo chlapca, snažia kontrolovať ich životy.
And as a result, there is no peace and joy between the partners.
A potom medzi partnermi nie je láska a pokoj.
And God says, what God has joined, that nobody put asunder or separate.
A to, čo čo Boh spojil, človek nech nerozlučuje.
For example, once a young man whose father died when he was small was very, very much attached to the mother.
Tak napríklad raz sa stalo jednému chlapcovi, ktorému otec zomrel ešte keď bol malý, tak ten chlapec bol veľmi naviazaný na svoju matku.
Then when this young man would see some girls whom he would like to get married and tell the mother, he said, no, that girl is bad, the family is bad, that is not fitting for our family.
A keď stretol nejaké dievča, ktoré sa mu páčilo, tak jeho matka povedala, nie, ona sa nehodí do našej rodiny, nie je pre nás hodná a jej rodina nie je dobrá pre nás.
So his marriage was delayed.
A jeho manželstvo bolo odložené.
Because this mother was very much attached to the son and the son was very much attached to the mother.
Pretože táto matka bola veľmi naviazaná na svojho syna a syn veľmi naviazaný na svoju matku.
Finally he met a girl in the church.
Napokon stretol jedno dievča v kostole.
And then he talked to her for a few hours.
Rozprával sa s ňou niekoľko hodín.
And then he continued to meet her for next 2 years.
A ďalšie 2 roky sa s ňou stretával.
So finally, after 2 years, she agreed to get married to him.
A po dvoch rokoch súhlasila, že si ho vezme.
And he told his parents, that I am going to marry only this girl and nobody else in my life.
A svojim rodičom, svojim mame povedal, že vezme si jedine toto dievča, nikoho iného.
Finally, the mother had to accept that marriage.
A napokon matka musela prijať toto manželstvo.
But from the next day of the marriage, there was a quarrel between mother and the daughter-in-law.
Avšak na druhý deň, už od ďalšieho dňa po uzavretí manželstva, sa neustále táto nevesta so svokrou hádali.
In the beginning, the daughter-in-law was not making, not reacting.
Z počiatku mladá žena nereagovala.
But afterwards she began to react to the mother-in-law.
Ale neskôr na svoju svokru začala reagovať.
And she felt as if she was a lamb in the cage of a tiger.
A cítila sa, že je ako keby ovečka, ktorá je v klietke s tigrom.
After some time she said, I don't want a child from this family.
A povedala si, začala sa, nechcem mať dieťa z tejto rodiny.
And she was not having a child.
a nemala dieťa.
After 3 years, this young lady said, I want a divorce, I cannot stay anymore here.
A po troch rokoch v manželstve táto mladá žena povedala, nechcem tu zostať, chcem rozvod.
Because the husband could not either side with the wife because he loved her, nor side with the mother because he loved her also.
Pretože tento manžel nedržal stranu ani svojej žene, pretože ju miloval, a nedržal stranu ani svojej matke, lebo aj ju miloval.
When they both would quarrel, she would get out.
Keď sa oni dve pohádali, on odišiel von.
And that made the wife feel lonely and helpless.
A táto žena sa potom cítila osamela a bez pomoci.
And after 3 years, she said, I want a divorce.
Po troch rokoch povedala, chcem sa rozviesť.
And then the family people came together and tried to send them to some psychologists and psychiatrists.
Potom sa stretla široká rodina a snažili sa ich poslať k psychologovi a k psychiatrovi.
But nothing happened.
Ale nič sa nestalo.
And then finally the family came together and decided that they both go separate away from the family of the mother.
A potom sa zase stretla celá rodina a rozhodli sa, že títo mladí ľudia sa oddelia od tej matky.
And though they stayed separate, once in a week he would come to see the mother. Once in a week, the man, husband, would come to see the mother.
Žili oddelene a raz do týždňa tento syn išiel navštíviť matku.
And when he comes back, he will be angry with his wife.
Keď sa vrátil naspäť, tak sa hníval na svoju manželku.
It's because of you that I cannot be with my family, with my mother and so on.
Kvôli tebe nemôžem byť so svojou rodinou, so svojou matkou.
Two more years passed.
Prešli ďalšie 2 roky.
The mother began to blame the daughter because you are bad, therefore God is not giving a child. It's a punishment.
A táto matka začala obviňovať dievča, si zlá, preto ti Boh nepožehná dieťaťom.
And after 2 years, that is after 5 years, she said, I cannot live anymore with this man and with this family. I want a divorce.
Po ďalších 5 rokoch si táto žena povedala, nemôžem žiť s týmto mužom ani s jeho rodinou, chcem sa rozviesť.
At that time, this husband happened to meet my companion priest in Bombay.
V tomto čase ten muž náhodou stretol jedného mojho priateľa v Bombaji.
And my companion priest told him if they want some solution, they could come to me. They both would come to me.
Bol to kňaz, takisto, a poradil im, aby obidvaja prišli za mnou.
They both came.
A prišli.
And then first I tried to know about both of them, about their early life before the marriage.
Najprv som chcel vedieť o ich živote pred manželstvom.
And then I called them together.
Potom som si ich zavolal k sebe spolu.
In the meantime I realized that he was very much attached to his mother.
A vtedy som si uvedomil, že je veľmi naviazaný na svoju matku.
Then I read out this sentence, Mark verse 9, 10 verse 9.
Prečítal som mu tento verš.
Or verse 79.
Z Mareka.
You can read that once again.
Preto muž opustí svojho otca i matku a pripúta sa k svojej manželke a budú dvaja v jednom tele. A tak už nie sú dvaja, ale jedno telo.
And therefore, what God says is that you must leave your emotional attachment to your mother and the father and be emotionally united with your partner.
A preto nám Boh hovorí, aby sme opustili emočné naviazanie na rodičov a emočne sa naviazali na svojho partnera.
And that is the reason your wife is not able to stay with you.
Toto je ten dôvod, prečo tvoja manželka nechce s tebou zostať.
She needs to get after God the next place in her life.
Potrebuje, aby si potom, ako budeš mať na prvom mieste, Boha dal ďalšie miesto jej.
If you are not giving that, then you are not living according to God's commandment.
Ak jej to nedávaš, nežiješ podľa Božích prikázaní.
He understood his mistake.
Pochopil svoju chybu.
Then he asked pardon from the Lord.
Poprosil Boha o odpustenie.
Pardon from the wife.
Takisto aj svoju ženu.
And also asked pardon for all the wrong things that he has done in the time of marriage till that time.
Poprosil o odpustenie za chyby, ktoré urobil od manželstva až do toho času.
And she was ready to forgive the husband for the wrong understanding.
Takisto aj ona bola ochotná odpustiť svojmu manželovi.
And then I prayed over them.
A modlil som sa za nich.
Then she also said, Father, I don't have a child. I don't have a child.
A ona mi povedala, pater, ale nemám dieťa.
I said, What did the doctor say about your ability to have a child?
Spýtal som sa, čo povedali lekári o tvojej plodnosti.
According to the doctor, there is no problem, but we are not having children.
Podľa lekárov, tu nie je žiadny problém, avšak dieťa nemáme.
Then I told her, you, in your anger, said, I did not want to have a child from this family.
Ty si v svojom hneve povedala, nechcem dieťa z tejto rodiny.
And the devil took that angry word and he is not allowing you to have a child.
Diabol si vzal tieto tvoje negatívne slova a ty nemáš dieťa.
But even the silly word that we say in our anger and so on, God takes it seriously.
A slova, ktoré vyriekneme v hneve, majú veľký význam.
And we must know what words that we speak.
Preto si musíme dávať pozor, čo hovoríme.
For example, we find in Matthew chapter 12,
v Matúšovom evanjeliu, v 12. kapitole,
verse 36,
verš 36. No hovorím vám, ľudia sa budú v deň súdu zodpovedať z každého daromného slova, ktoré vyslovia.
For every careless word you have given you an account for the Lord.
Z každého daromného slova, ktoré vyslovia pred Bohom.
She said, I don't want a child from this family.
Ona povedala, nechcem dieťa z tejto rodiny.
God accepted it.
A Boh to prijal.
So there was no child.
A preto tam to dieťa nebolo.
Then I ask pardon from the Lord.
A tedy som jej povedal, pros Boha o odpustenie.
Lord, I forgive my mother-in-law.
Pane, prosím ťa o odpustenie, odpúšťam svoje svokre.
Lord, I want a child.
Pane, chcem dieťa.
I take back my last the curse that I put on myself.
Tú kliatbu, ktorú som nad sebou vyriekla, si chcem vziať späť.
And then I prayed over her.
A potom som sa za ňu modlil.
They went back very happily.
Boli šťastní, keď odchádzali.
Though the girl never believed that husband could change.
Avšak to dievča si nemyslel, že ten chlapec sa zmení.
But when he understood the truth or the failure of his life, he was ready to change.
A keď pochopil, v čom zlyhal vo svojom živote, tak sa naozaj zmenil.
After 2.5 months, I get a letter.
A po 2.5 mesiaci som dostal list.
Father, when we left from there, my wife was not believing that I would change.
A písalo sa tam, Pater, keď sme od vás odchádzali, moja žena neverila, že sa zmením.
Now, I have changed according to the way you directed me.
A zmenil som sa spôsobom, akým ste mi povedali.
Now, I am giving importance for her in my life.
Dávam jej dôležitosť vo svojom živote.
We pray together.
Modlíme sa spolu.
We help one another.
Pomáhame si navzájom.
We appreciate one another.
Oceňujeme sa.
We are really happy.
A sme naozaj šťastní.
And there's a happy news to inform you.
A ešte máme jednu radostnú správu.
Do you know what it is?
A viete, čo to je? Child.
Yes.
Áno.
So, when, therefore, our every word is important.
A preto každé jedno slovo je dôležité.
When people get angry, they speak uncontrollable words to the partner that may affect your life.
Keď sa ľudia nahnevajú, tak nekontrolujú slova, ktoré vyslovujú nad svojim partnerom.
We must know what we speak is helpful to build up the relationship or destroy the relationship.
A musíme hovoriť slova, ktoré budujú tento vzťah, nie ho ničia.
And therefore we hear in Matthew 12, verse 37.
A v Matúšovi, v 12. kapitole, verš 37, čítame. Lebo podľa svojich slov budeš ospravedlnený a podľa svojich slov budeš odsúdený.
So, if I first a condemnation, hatred, quarrel, and it will make you guilty.
A pokiaľ tam bude prítomné odsúdenie alebo hádky, budeme sa cítiť vinní.
It is going to destroy your family life.
A zničí nám to náš rodinný život.
Whereas we are appreciating, affirming, loving, and we are the helpful words to the partner, then you'll have a very good family life.
Ak sme milujúci, ak vyslovujeme slova uznania, ocenenia voči svojmu partnerovi, tak tedy budeme viesť dobrý život.
I don't know whether you heard about the great or the first philosopher, Socrates.
Socrates? Ale neviem, či ste počuli o Sokratovi?
Have you heard? Yes. He was condemned to death because the city people said he was spoiling the young people.
A bol odsúdený na smrť, pretože ľudia z mesta tvrdili, že ničí mladých ľudí.
And then people asked him, how do you feel about the condemnation to death?
A ľudia sa ho spýtali, ako sa cítite, keď budete odsúdení na smrť.
He said, it is better to die than be with my wife.
A on povedal, je lepšie zomrieť, než byť s mojou ženou.
Why? Prečo? Here only condemnation, accusation, rejection.
Pretože zakúšal iba odsúdenie a odmietanie.
So remember, with your own words, you build the family. With your own words, you destroy your family.
Svojimi slovami budujete rodinu, svojimi slovami ničíte rodinu.
And you must know what words that you speak.
Musíte si vážiť slova, ktoré vyslovíte.
And when you do that, when you do as a Christian, with the loving words, you build the family.
Keď budete konať ako kresťania, s milujúcimi slovami, tak tedy naozaj milujete svoju rodinu.
If you do any other way, you may destroy the family.
Inými spôsobmi budete svoju rodinu ničiť.
The Russian author, what is it name? Famous Russian author, I forget the name. He has got Nobel Prize and so on.
I don't know.
So starting with S. Anyway,
jeden nositeľ Nobelovej ceny.
And in the beginning he was publishing, the government was publishing all that he was saying and so on.
A tak spočiatku on bol nositeľ Nobelovej ceny a spočiatku vláda vytlačala jeho publikácie.
And his wife was very happy with him, there were plenty of money.
A jeho žena bola veľmi spokojná, pretože mali dostatok peňazí.
And then he became a Christian.
Potom sa stal kresťanom.
And then his lifestyle changed. Lifestyle changed.
A zmenil sa mu životný štýl.
He became a simple person.
A stal sa z neho jednoduchý človek.
And his wife began to hate that.
A jeho žena ma to nenávidela.
Because she had not a faith, she wanted glamour, money, fame and so on.
Nemala slávu, ona chcela teda nemala vieru, ale ona chcela slávu a peniaze.
And afterwards, it was difficult for him to live with her.
A pre ňoho to začalo byť ťažké žiť s ňou.
At the age of 82, he left the family.
Keď mal 82 rokov, svoju rodinu opustil.
After 2 weeks, his body was found in a railway station because he died out of pneumonia.
A po 2 týždňoch jeho telo našli na železničnej stanici, pretože zomrel na zápal plúc.
Some years later, his wife was on the deathbed.
O niekoľko rokov neskôr jeho žena bola na smrteľnej posteli.
And she told her 2 children, 2 girls.
A svojim 2 dcerám povedala.
I am responsible for the death of my husband.
Som zodpovedná za smrť svojho manžela.
Dear friends, our life is only once lived together.
Drahí priatelia, náš život žijeme iba raz.
And let us live this life to give love and not show hate and selfishness.
Žijeme tento život, aby sme dávali lásku a nepreukazovali nenávisť a sebectvo.
By your good life, you build the family.
Cez dobrý život budujeme rodinu.
By your bad life, destroy yourself, the partner and the children and the next generation.
Zlým spôsobom života ničíme samých seba, svojho partnera, deti a ďalšie generácie.
And therefore, dear friends, let us understand how we are living our life.
A preto, drahí priatelia, uvedomme si, ako žijeme svoje životy.
The marital life is not only for the sexual relationship.
Manželský život nie je iba o sexuálnom spolunažívaní.
Sexual relations is important.
Sexuálne spolunažívanie je veľmi dôležité.
They also must be faithful to one another.
A musíme byť verní jeden druhému.
And if they have that faithfulness and readiness to serve the other, then the family will succeed.
Ak je tu vernosť a ochota slúžiť druhému, tak tá rodina bude úspešná.
They also need respect to one another.
A musia sa rešpektovať navzájom.
So, for example, we find in Ephesians chapter 5, verse 33.
V liste Efezanom, 5. kapitole, verš 33. Ale aj vy, každý jeden, nech miluje svoju manželku ako seba samého. A manželka, nech si ctí muža.
Sorry.
This time, I just finished. Therefore, it is duty. The husband loves the wife, and the wife respects the husband.
Manžel nech miluje svoju manželku a manželka nech si ctí muža.
We shall be out for a minute. You shall be out for half an hour.
A teraz si dáme prestávku 30 minút.
Stop it.